Hey guys, so today I want to talk to you about diagnostic tools. Now, I only want to talk about one tool today, but when you're working on vehicle electronics, whether it be the audio system or just the basic general electrical system in a vehicle, there is a plethora of electrical diagnostic tools and testing tools you can use in order to work on a vehicle properly and safely, from, you know, just a regular amplified speaker to a tone generator, the good old trusted multimeter, scan tools. These both are scan tools. And today what we're going to talk about is the Power Probe 3. Now this device is actually kind of does some of the things that these devices do, but you know, it's all packaged into one. Now I'm not going to say that this is going to replace all these tools. No, if you're actually really serious about it, you should actually own all these tools. But with this thing, I can actually check continuity with it, I can check voltage, I can send power and ground through it, you know, it does all that stuff for
you.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you this device in use and how I use it on an everyday basis and how useful it can be. I do want to note that this should be used in the hands of a trained professional. If you're using this on a CAN bus system, you can. I do a lot, but I am fully aware of what this can do and what it can't do and what a CAN bus system's nature is. So, you know, you can wreck computers with this if you're not careful. It's really easy to use on a standard vehicle with a regular 12-volt system, like a 1990 Honda Civic, for example. Like, those are pretty hard to hurt. But, you know, if you know how to use this properly and you know the vehicle that you're working on, you can actually get a lot of work done very easily with this. So with the Power Probe 3, we can also do a continuity test. So here we just have a spare piece of wire, hook up your alligator clip, which is hooked up to ground at the battery, and then touch it with your Power Probe. As you see, it goes green or negative. I'll have the speaker turn on for you guys. So now you know you have continuity through this wire. So for this example, we're actually testing a diode. So on the diode, we have the strip on this side, so only negative can flow this way. So you see, got negative there and negative on this side. Now if we flip it around, also I want to know is the Power Probe 3 is very sensitive. So because of the diode, it's not going to give me a really strong ground signal, but the zeros that you see on there, if you can see them, that means it's ground. So let's flip the diode around the other way. So, ground, but nothing coming through, which means this diode is working properly. So like I said before, you can actually send ground or positive through on the Power Probe. So you can pretty much turn off or on any 12 volt device. So I got my alligator clip on the grounding post on this light, and then you see here, so the circuit is complete and I can actually turn on. Another neat thing with the Power Probe is you can actually listen to speaker outputs off a speaker with the built-in speaker on the Power Probe 3. So just hook it up to the one channel, an active channel. Now obviously it doesn't sound that clear, but at least I can tell that, hey, yeah, your left front speaker is working on this side. The other great thing about the Power Probe is it's a great way to test fuses, so. So as you can see, I can actually see what each side of this fuse is and if there's any breaks in the line. So if there was a break in this fuse, this side would be positive, for example, and then that side would show negative instead. There are very rare cases where a fuse will show positive on both sides and still be broken. So if you know you have a blown fuse and all your fuses check out with your Power Probe, that's when it's time to break out the multimeter and do a continuity test. But for like 98% of the time, the Power Probe is a quick and easy way to check your fuses. Another great thing the Power Probe is great for doing is testing your cigarette lighter, making sure you actually have power. So on the outside is the grounding is your ground. So that's all good. And your center post is your positive. So this one checks out good. So here we're gonna test the voltage with the Power Probe. So I got it hooked up to the battery, turn on, I'm registering 12.1. Now when we start the motor, it's gonna go up. So now we're registering 14 volts with the motor running. Another cool thing is the Power Probe can actually store a reading in it. Say that you're by yourself and you need to check a circuit that's far away, you need to control the vehicle from another point of the vehicle. So all we gotta do is hold our mode button, hit positive, and let's just pretend that we're turning on a switch. I'm just gonna actually just touch positive right here, and let's just pretend I'm somewhere else in the vehicle. Power probe's not touching anything right now. We're gonna tap it. So it captured 12.7 volts, and then when I come walk around the vehicle again, it's showing me what the voltage read. You can also do it the opposite way, setting it to that, and you can actually monitor voltage drops in it. So, you know, there's a lot of cool things you can do with this thing. And when working in a 12 volt environment, the power probe's great when you're trying to find power or ground. So, or you can mute it if you don't like listening to it and just watch the light. Or we can check over here where the factory ground is. Another cool thing with the power probe is we can test all our ignition wiring with it. So we're gonna test the starter. So you'll see it blip to positive when I hit the starter on it. And I'll show you again with the actual audio indicator showing ground. Another thing you do with the power probe, you can actually send power down the line. Now, you want to be a seasoned technician or someone that's really good with electrical. Don't just be feeding power into everything. And also, in this vehicle, yellow's is the starter line. Well, guess what? This yellow over here is airbag. So you want to be careful where you're actually testing. So before you saw me control the starter, I can also control other parts of the vehicle too, like the lights, for example. So typically the power probe hooks up with these alligator clips on the battery, and it's got a nice long 20-foot cable roughly. This way you can get around the whole vehicle wherever you want to test. And you can also get extensions for this too. This just unclips. Let's say you're working inside the vehicle and you don't have an option and you can't get the battery for whatever reason. It also comes with an attachment for your cigarette lighter. So here's the power probe. We're around a 2007 Camry. And I'm using the stock length wire, so as you can see, it's more than long enough to come around the back of the vehicle and do any testing. If it's still not long enough, there's an extension. So here I got the extension on the power probe, so you can see I'm at the back of the shop. Car's all the way over there. I got a bunch of slack on the in the line, and I'm pretty much at the door now. This is great when you're working on some sort of semi-truck or motorhome.